For this video, we're going to take a look at credit card payment processing via an integration of the Stripe payment platform and a FileMaker solution. What you see here is the demo file you can download at the end of this article. First, there are a few setup steps we need to complete before we can get to the payment processing. Number one, we need to install the Base Element plugin. It comes with a bunch of functions and we use a couple of them. So if you don't already have it installed, depending on what operating system you're running, you click on the appropriate button. If the plugin is successfully installed, you'll get this dialog and the step will be checked off. Next, you need to create a Stripe account. You can follow the link right here. That'll take you to the creation page. You just need to enter in your email address, a password, and confirm that password, and then you can create your account. New accounts are set up for testing, so we don't need to fiddle with any settings. I'll bounce over to my existing account here. Stripe has a dashboard, and we need to get one piece of information. Click on Your Account, Account Settings, and API Keys. Stripe, as you can see, provides four keys. These are the way by which Stripe identifies who we are and that we actually have an account and we're legit. For our purposes, we're looking for the test secret key. That's the first key, so I'm going to copy that, hide my browser. I'm going to mark off that I have an account. I'm going to paste in my key and mark that step off. And now let's do some testing. For payment processing, for what we're going to look at, there are two steps. We need to create a customer, at least one. We could create more if we want to. And then we can process payments for that customer. What a customer does is it allows us to create a multiple use payment method. For us, it's going to be credit card related, but you could do bank accounts and other things with Stripe if you wanted to. So I'm just going to get in here and create a customer. These placeholder values for the credit card information are valid for testing, so you could just enter them in as you see here versus trying to come up with something on your own. So that's what I'll do. And I'm going to create this customer. And when I do that, this information is going to get sent to Stripe along with our key saying we're legit and we have an account. Stripe's going to make sure it's valid. Stripe has extensive error checking. And whenever something goes wrong, it lets you know. And if it's successful, though, it's going to store that information and it's going to send back information that isn't sensitive. So anything that's sensitive here, like the full credit card number and the CVC, we're not going to get back. Stripe keeps that on their servers. Their servers are certified to the highest level of the payment processing industry. And that's a great thing. What it sends us back includes an ID. And that ID from now on is how we charge this account. As long as we send that ID along when we process a payment, it's going to utilize this information. So I'm going to send this along, create this customer. Clear out that info, so that's for security too. I don't want to keep sensitive information. Stripe is doing it for me, and that's a great thing. Customer was successfully created. I can go down. I can see that I've got a couple customers before now, but here's Arthur. I can select him. I can charge him $1,000. And again, this charge info, the amount, his account, which is that ID that I just got back when I created him, is going to get sent now to Stripe saying, hey, charge this account. Success. I've just charged his credit card $1,000. And it's that simple. I could now say it's a couple months from now, and for whatever reason, other things have come up, and I need to charge him $80. I reset, and then I charge again. Charge is successful. And I can keep charging his account as I need. I don't have to re-enter the information, which is convenient for the user if they're having to do it. It's convenient for business owners if they're taking in payment information at a time that is not the exact same time they're charging the account, or they need to charge the account multiple times. And again, it's secure. Stripe has all the sensitive information. What we're dealing with in FileMaker is just IDs. And those IDs are all we need. We can take a quick look here. We have some data view for those that are interested. Every attempt that's made to create a customer as well as process a charge is stored, whether or not it's successful or an error. As I said, Stripe has extensive error checking. It returns an error object. All things that Stripe returns, as you may notice here, are in JSON, so it's easy to parse out and get the information you need, figure out what went wrong. In this case, we can see, oh, I forgot to put my API key in. That was silly of me. So that's why that failed. Whereas I have these three successes. And then I have my charges here. I can see I have charge objects containing a bunch of information. You can include an email for a receipt. You can include address information. You can include verification by zip code if you so choose. And there's a lot to it. And it's a really powerful platform to utilize. And so there you have it. As I noted, there errors can occur. For example, here, wait a sec. I didn't put anything in. So it returns the info. I parse it out and let you know something went wrong. Same down here. Well, I forgot to charge them any value. So there's easy to report back information and figure out what went wrong and fix it. For, you know, someone that's actually using this and it is not trying to parse out the specifics. If we take a look at the backend and the scripts, they're just two very simple scripts. And they both follow the same process. Here I have a bunch of variables when I'm creating my customer that are set by the information I entered in, name, card number, expiration info, on. I make sure that they aren't duplicate for our purposes. Names have to be unique, but they don't have to be in the real world. I create the record. I then use that custom, one of the custom functions from base elements to send the info to Stripe. Bunch of parameters there on the HTTP post. If it's successful and not an error, I keep going. If it is an error, I store the error and quit. Store a bit of information if it's successful and clear out the sensitive payment information that I don't want to keep any longer than I have to. On the charge side, again, we set some variables. Stripe processes payments as the lowest denomination of the currency. For our purposes, we're doing US dollars, so that's pennies. So there is a conversion factor I have in here to make sure that if I put in 10 bucks, I'm actually getting 1,000 pennies. Once again, make sure that there's a customer, brief error trapping there, create the record, send the post request for that charge. If there's an error, I store that error and quit out. If there isn't and everything is successful, at least between me and Stripe, I store some information about that, and then I clear out the charge amount. Now, when I said, if you might have caught there, if everything's successful between me and Stripe, Stripe can't tell what's in someone's bank account. The bank knows that. Stripe can't necessarily tell right away if a card has been put on hold. So as long as everything checks out between the FileMaker solution and Stripe when it comes to the info for processing a payment, Stripe's going to say success. But then at the end, that little status is going to tell you whether or not the charge itself succeeded. For testing purposes, they always succeed. But they can be declined. And that is something, you know, you'll need to deal with and could happen. Because like I said, Stripe doesn't necessarily know the exact status of the account until it tries to charge it. And that's it. Pretty straightforward, pretty simple, and very secure.